When you hear about labor abuse, you might first think of sweatshops in countries like China. Yet labor abuse is also happening closer than we think, in the very heart of Europe, on the same roads where we happily drive our cars. Investigate Europe traveled along Europe's highways and interviewed haulage drivers in their trucks, the places where they spend up to two-thirds of their lives. These highway nomads are mostly immigrants and are commonly paid much less than the minimum wages in the countries where they work. They often have no health insurance, no paid holidays, few days off, and face exhaustion and stress on the job. They live for weeks in spaces no bigger than 4 square meters by the side of the road, sleeping, cooking, eating, and relieving themselves aboard their trucks or in parking lots. It all started in the name of free movement. Transport was liberalized. In order to cut costs and increase profits, haulage companies started hiring drivers from Eastern Europe. But the race to the bottom for cheaper labor didn't stop there. Currently, many haulage drivers in Europe are non-EU nationals, from countries like Ukraine, Moldova, Belarus, Kazakhstan, and the Philippines. Who benefits from this? At first glance, it is the haulage companies who employ the drivers. But a closer look at the chain of responsibility reveals that those driving the labor abuse are those who hire the haulage companies to transport goods. And among the worst offenders are car makers. Renault, BMW, Jaguar Land Rover, and Volkswagen are just a few of the companies whose culpability is exposed by documents in Investigate Europe's possession. Sweatshops on wheels. This is the dark secret behind many supposedly ethical cars.